I get a lot of questions around how I edit my YouTube videos, so that's what I'm gonna show you guys today. What up, friends? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Tina. For those that don't already know, I do a lot of editing tutorials, especially with Snapseed. Today, I'm coming at you with something a little bit different. So if you do use Adobe Premiere, I'm going to share tips to make your editing process a lot quicker. Also, where I find all the copyright-free music for my videos. Also, how I film my tutorials in general. So let's get right into it. So the very first thing you want to do, no matter what program you use to edit, is get organized. You're gonna want to have all your different assets and video clips in one folder. And with Adobe Premiere, you can actually just drag that folder into the project library. It's gonna import all your files. Very next thing that you'll wanna do is you're gonna want to label your clips. For those that are OCD in terms of color coordinating their outfits, their closet, their binders, their school notes, etc., you are going to love this feature. So you can label all your clips ahead of time while still in the project library under your folder, or you can actually do this after you import your clips onto your timeline. I like to kind of label them as I go. It really helps in terms of identifying kind of your blooper clips. If you're filming a lookbook, you can group all your looks by labeling them with different colors. It works really well with tutorials as well. If your tutorial consists of 7 steps, you can label all your steps with different colors. So this is going to completely change the way you edit, and especially if you're dealing with 1,000 clips at one time, it's going to help you edit quicker and it's going to save you so much time in the long run. I don't use an iPhone. I know there's a screen recording feature within iPhones. Unfortunately, Androids don't have that. I use an app called AZ Screen Recorder to record my screen. So especially when I'm doing Snapseed tutorials, I'll screen record my phone as I'm editing a picture, and then I'll film the talking part separately, the same way I'm doing it for this tutorial, and then I put the clips together when I edit. If you want to record something on your computer or laptop, QuickTime is an amazing app. It makes it really easy for you to screen record kind of anything that you're doing on your computer. So whether that be a Photoshop or some type of editing tutorial, you can do it that way as well. The next tip is using adjustment layers. Whenever you're making any edits to your clips, whether that be in terms of color grading or adding any type of effect to it, it's highly recommend that you use adjustment layers, and here's why. If you wanna apply that same effect to multiple clips, it's going to make it so much easier because you can just have all the clips that you want the added effect to apply to under that adjustment layer versus kind of copy and pasting the attributes over to multiple clips. Secondly, if you decide that you don't like a certain edit that you made, you can simply delete the adjustment layer. It's always good to have the original clip on hand in case you want to duplicate it or use it for another purpose. So always use adjustment layers. All right, so for music, if you wanna start monetizing your video and if you don't want it to be hit with a copyright, use copyright-free music. So my favorite channel for royalty-free and copyright-free music is Audio Library. They have a variety of different kinds of music, depending on whatever mood that you want your video to portray. So whether that be happy, inspirational music or more moody, ambient music, all the way to more vocal-free vlog music, whatever you're in the mood for, they have it. There's a bunch of other sites and channels that offer it as well. Even if you do a quick search in YouTube and just do copyright-free music, you're going to get a bunch of hits. So there's a lot of options out there. I also find that music is kind of the hardest part in terms of the editing process. It can make or break any type of video. So don't underestimate the power of music. So because I do a lot of tutorials, having visual aids definitely helps in terms of laying out that step-by-step process. So I love using green screens. If you just search on YouTube, like subscribe animated green screen or like button green screen, there's a lot of free ones that you can find and use. And it's really easy to use it in your videos. All you have to do is within the effects panel, type in Alt key, add that effect onto the green screen video that you added in. Use that eyedrop icon to click on the green and it'll erase the green background. You're free to use it wherever. It also saves a lot of time because someone's already put that effort into making those animated lower thirds. Because I don't know how to use After Effects, this is a really easy workaround. So if you have a lot of clips that you've edited and you have a bunch of gaps where normally you would kind of ripple delete manually one by one, there's actually a really quick way for you to mass ripple delete that is going to make you so much more efficient in terms of your editing process. So let's say I have a bunch of clips here and all these gaps I want to ripple delete at once. All you have to do is add a color mat or adjustment layer on top of it, drag all all your selected clips into that layer, then drag all the clips down. Now you notice that that layer has been cut with those clips. Select all the different sections of that layer, right click and click ripple delete. And now all your gaps are filled. Now you won't have to manually ripple delete each kind of section or gap. You're welcome. All right, this is going to completely elevate your editing game. Know your shortcuts. Once you know your shortcuts, it's going to take you from noob to pro in mere seconds. All right, so there's 6 shortcuts that I wanna show y'all that I frequently use. If these shortcuts don't line up with what the functionalities within your Adobe Premiere, you can always adjust those in settings. All these shortcuts are relevant to Mac users because I use a Mac. I'm gonna have the PC versions of the shortcuts here as well. To trim your clip or select the razor tool, instead of having to do it manually, all you have to do is click C on your keyboard and that will select the razor tool automatically. And if you want to unselect the tool, then all you have to do is click V. If you want to quickly copy a clip over instead of right clicking and clicking copy, if you just pull down option on your keyboard and drag the clip over, it's going to automatically copy it for you. Okay, so I recently learned this shortcut and it is a game changer. So let's say you're done editing your video and then you realize that you forgot a clip. So instead of going to where you want to add it and selecting everything to the right of it or to the left of it and moving it manually, all you have to do is click on the section of the timeline that you want to add that extra clip in, hold down A, and it's going to select all the clips to the right of where your pointer is. If you want to select everything to the left of where your cursor is, just hold down Shift, click A again, and it's going to do that for you. Now you are free to add whatever clip that you want to add or make whatever adjustments you want to do, and it's that easy. And then lastly, sometimes the exporting process takes a really long time. Instead of waiting around and twiddling your thumbs, if you go into export, but instead of clicking export, you're going to click Q. So this way you can actually edit another video or export a thumbnail and start working on your thumbnail while your video is exporting. So talk about multitasking. Okay, so that is how I edit all of my YouTube tutorials, and those are all the tips on how you can elevate your editing game and how I've been able to make my editing process more efficient so that I can use the extra time to binge an extra show on Netflix or eat. So if you guys have other shortcuts or tips that you want to share, feel free to let me know in the comments. If you love this tutorial and you want more, give this video a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed, then what is you doing? Feel free to stalk me on Instagram and TikTok for days where you're waiting for a new video. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.
Okay, bye.